My early research had to do with cell adhesion, and although I started it many more years ago than I care to think about, I still do some of that work, and my recent work is a derivation of it. What we set out to do is to understand what keeps normal cells in their place in the body. The original hypothesis was that there would be a cell surface recognition mechanism that accomplished this task. And of course, no molecules were known at that time that would work in such a way. So it was all new. But that led us experiments that we developed to study this possibility led us to what we later on named fibronectin, which is a prototype cell adhesion molecule. And then we worked on fibronectin and particularly on its cell attachment site, which we got down to a very small peptide that has then became the basis of some drugs and is still much used in the clinic and in clinical trials and so on. We then also identified receptors that bind to this peptide, now known as integrins. The cell attachment site we identified in fibronectin consists only of three amino acids: arginine, glycine, and aspartic acid, and by the one-letter code that is currently mostly used, it translates into RGD. So the RGD peptide was remarkable because it was so small. The fibronectin molecule has 3,000 amino acids, almost 3,000 amino acids, and yet only three of them were the key to the binding of cells to this protein. The use of RGD in the clinic, the first uses were to prevent the aggregation of the small blood cells that cause blood clotting and participate in blood clotting the platelets. It turns out that they aggregate based on this RGD integrin chemistry, and that could be inhibited with the soluble RGD peptides. Now, it then turns out that the peptides themselves also have an effect on cancer. And there's one drug in clinical trials that makes use of the ability of RGD to prevent the growth of tumor cells. Or it actually affects more the blood vessels that nurture the tumor. So currently my laboratory works on what I call vascular zip codes. We found a way of studying the vasculature in a live mouse, looking for differences in the inner lining of blood vessels from one tissue to another, from one pathology to another, and so forth. And it turns out that there is a tremendous amount of heterogeneity in the inner lining of blood vessels, even though they pretty much look the same, but molecularly they are not the same. Tissues and pathological lesions put their signature on their vasculature, and we find those signatures. And one of the signatures actually is the integrins that bind to RGD. So RGD peptides are used a lot to deliver things directly into tumors.